First of all, I just want to officially move the motion this evening, and I'm delighted to introduce this motion to the Dáil for debate. I want to acknowledge the involvement of our stakeholders who, due to COVID restrictions, cannot be with us today, and I want to thank each and every one of them for their campaigning, for their advice and for their expert opinion. This motion was drafted in close consultation with the childcare and early years sector and has been significantly influenced by the hundreds of emails from parents, workers, providers in the sector that both myself and my Sinn Féin colleagues have received. Families are crying out for a high quality childcare system that is affordable, accessible and sustainable. I think it's obvious to everyone here tonight and in the wider public that the early years sector in Ireland is in crisis. The current funding model is failing everyone. It's failing children, their families, their educators and childcare providers. As the party spokesperson on children, disability, equality and integration, and as the mother of two boys, I'm keenly aware on a personal level the serious issues facing the sector. Childcare was in crisis before COVID, during COVID, and it will remain in crisis after COVID if the government does not seriously commit to sustainable investment in the sector. I and my colleagues in Sinn Féin believe strongly that this phase in a young child's life should be recognised as a distinct phase with unique learning and developmental requirements, and all funding models should reflect this. Whilst other parties suggest tax credits will reduce costs, they will do nothing to address the pay of the workers, and the childcare sector and the workers deserve better. I am constantly contacted by parents, workers and providers wanting to share their experience of using, working and operating in, unfortunately, what has become a broken system. And I know I'm not the only TD in this room tonight that's witnessing the failings of the current funding model in their own home constituency. The major issue facing this sector is sustainable funding. Our early years sector must be resourced adequately to provide lower fees for parents, stability for workers and sustainable businesses for providers. There are three main areas that this motion seeks to address, so I'm going to address them individually. Firstly, the workers. Of the approximate 30,000 workers in the early years sector, many of whom have spent several years at college studying and furthering their professional development and are extremely experienced and qualified, after a lifetime in the sector, are still earning less than the living wage. Many don't get sick leave. Many have to sign on to social welfare during the summer break. Yesterday, SIPTU published a survey, the Big Start campaign, and it shows that more than a quarter of all surveyed have suffered significant pay cuts post-COVID. It also worryingly showed that 32% indicated that they intend to leave the sector due to low pay. And I know that they do not want to leave the sector, but they're being forced out. This needs to be addressed. And one move that the government could make immediately is to reinstate the wage subsidy scheme and extend it past the end of 2020. Workers will have certainty and providers can concentrate on educating our young citizens. In response to COVID, a key and critical component of our plan was implemented. The state took on the wage bill, so it is possible to do this. Parents. Parents are burdened with some of the highest fees in Europe, which evidence shows creates a significant barrier to maternal employment. Women are adversely affected by higher fees, with many forced to stay out of the workforce while their children are small. And providers. As workers and parents are squeezed at one end of the system, childcare providers, mainly small businesses and predominantly managed and owned by women, are being squeezed at the other end. The vast majority of childcare providers are delivering high-quality education to our young children at an important stage in their learning and emotional development. The programme for government rightly states that childcare should promote quality, better outcomes for children and make a career in childcare more attractive. But what exactly is the government's plan to deliver this? To date, we have seen lower wages for its workers, parents have more or less been guaranteed fees will continue to rise, and providers fear closure due to inadequate funding. The motion I put before you this evening sets out three clear objectives that Sinn Féin believes will deliver a fairer deal for the provision of childcare in Ireland. We are failing children, we are failing workers, and we are failing childcare providers if this motion is not passed. And I'm asking all TDs here tonight to please support this motion, and let's finally give childcare and the early years sector the funding and the recognition it deserves. Cormac.